how do you deal with injury? Because I did a very bad decision with my shoulder, keep on riding, strapping for 2 months, and now it's just a disaster. So that's, I guess that's just not the thing to do.
No, that's a problem. You go to the gym to avoid those big crashes and to be able, you're tougher when you hit the ground. And obviously when you don't do that that proper job before the season coming, you're going to pay sooner or later by fatigues. Your body can just not take it, especially when you do so many runs, you know? Like, your body is going to be, all right, I have enough. You crash, like what happened to you, shoulder out of the place, you put back together and you think it's okay, next day I put a strap and I go riding. No, that's why sometimes we need to take some time off, like even a couple days, just to rebuild your body, do something different, you know, relax and try to put some electrostimulation as well to try to bring back together what you've been damaged. But when you do those jobs before in the gym, like all those little exercises, was going to basically build a chill around you. Like when you crash, you just don't have only the protection, but your body is just prepared for the impact, you know? Then,
if I understand correctly, is the way the fiber of the muscle is worked out is different from just lifting weights and getting big muscles.
Exactly. It's not lifting weights going to make you tougher when you eat shit. That's all the little exercise, the little fibers of your muscle. That's why you have to work on the deep tissue about, you know, sometimes you see people at the gym, they're pretty strong and they work on the just little weights or just elastic or TRX, because proprio and all those stuff are good to make you work your muscle, no, in terms of like making it big, just making it more dense and more fiber. This help a lot, and especially in biking you have to be that way, because if you're huge, you can be huge and look like you have big muscle, you cannot move on the bike, and when you hit a tree it will hurt exactly the same. Then it's a different way to work in mountain biking. That's why I did a big video, like for my clients, my students on the CG Fun Camp Online, because they will probably be amazed as like how much you can do even at home with just like little things like TRX pumps and all those things. You're not going to be huge, but you're going to be more dense, like more your muscle is going to be a lot more thick. And that's definitely the way when you eat shit is going to help your life.
Well, you told me your training was inspired by the training of the Russians, special forces,
yeah.
Right?
Russian forces. Russian
that's
forces.
That's crazy.
Like, yeah, like the old school, basically what everyone call now CrossFit. But they call it CrossFit because they have to find something new to bring people to do exercises. But I always do like old school. I don't do those new technique, like you know, like squats and
mountain biking.
I just do the old school way, like the right exercise when people was doing before. That's not me. That's my trainer. Is like, hey, Cedric, let's cut the bullshit. Let's go straight to the real work. You're never going to stay more than 2 hours in the gym, an hour 15. But the way we're going to do it as a circuit training, that's the way it works. And that's why he was my trainer, because I didn't know anything. I need to be guide, and it definitely make a big difference for me. Because if I didn't have this building and he did to me, I would definitely be in the worst shape today after all those accidents.
So what you tell me is after a certain level, meaning after you're done having fun just doing laps and you want to do something else, before dealing with the injury, you have to prevent the injury.
Yeah, you have to prevent. It's like when you go skiing, you cannot show up into a skiing and do a lot of runs because you're exciting with the winter. If you don't have the job done before the winter is coming, in terms of like making your knee stronger, making your legs stronger, yeah, you're going to damage yourself. If you do once a week, it's okay. But if you go like 4 times a week and you go quite a lot skiing, yeah, like the intensity of doing so many runs, like you do in mountain biking, yeah, your body is just not prepared. It's okay for a couple weeks, but I mean, if you don't go to the beach for a week to recover your body, man, you're going to snap like a piece of dry wood. And it's normal because you do too much intensity for what, even if you look like a big person, and I mean, you're a bigger person, that don't mean anything. That just for you is like, oh, I'm a big man, I should be able to take it, but look, you're shorter now. But that's,
and what you told me is also the rest is very important part of the training. That's when your body basically upscales.
Yep.
And then gets ready for the next round.
Like 50 to 60% of your the increment of your body after hard working is resting. Mm. Because that's where your muscle recover and put everything together to be, okay, now I'm ready again, we can put the charge. That's why when you see everyone every day at the gym,
yeah,
I mean, you're just using your body, like, hard. Mm. You need those days off, like, I know they're hard, especially when you come to the weekend and they tell you, okay, the bike park is open, but your trainer tell you, like, no riding this weekend. And you're like, what do you mean? I want to ride. Like, I've been training and I want to ride. No, it's like, nope. You need to rest. If not, with all the travel, all the intensity you do, your body is just going to snap in June. And when you're racing, you always have to look for your peaks and stuff. Then it was hard, especially when you live in the bike park like this. You want to ride every day and you want to ride for you as well and your mates. Then I couldn't. Now I can because I don't race. But yeah, it was so hard to look at everyone having fun and you have to stay home. Then you bring them for barbecues. Then you prepare the barbecue for the boys. And you're like, I was a ride. And but at the end of the day, it just give you even more. You want to ride more. Like, you know, when you have those 2 days off on Monday, you just want to go to the trail and just break it.
Well, that's basically what the physical therapist told me. Is like, you got two options. You can tell me off and don't do anything.
Yeah, don't listen.
And just wait for the next crash to go to the hospital and get your shoulder fixed.
And you will lose more time.
Yeah, or go to the gym. So yeah, I'm understanding that it's getting like a work again now.
Well, it is. Well, if you wasn't riding as much, and if you weren't riding as much, it would not be a problem. But because you start to have so much riding into you, then you almost become a professional now. Then, but you don't have a body of a professional because you didn't do the job before. Then now, I guess you have to do the job for next year or the job for the winter coming, because we're going to do some randonnée, some touring. And touring, you don't show up into the touring without not having a base. That's for sure.
Okay, well, thank you for the advice. Well, the end of the season, bike park is closing soon, and I'm already gym climbing, turbo trainer. Wow.
Yep. Well, welcome to my world. Lies, get to work.
All right, bye.
See you later.